Hi everyone, this is Mario Hartnick speaking, and I'm going to introduce you quickly to the Computer Practice in 5 new textbook. But just to remind you, we do have Succeeding Introductory Computer Practice and Succeeding Computer Practice in 4 already in circulation based on the new curriculum that has started in the first semester of 2021. Moving over to the next semester of 2021, we are going to deal with Computer Practice in 5. And now, what can you expect from the Computer Practice in 5 textbook? We have our new modules. I'm going to specifically focus on the parts in blue because those were the practical parts, basically. The two theory modules that we're going to discuss is Module 1 and Module 2, Introduction to Concepts of ICT, which is basically your digital citizenship content that's going to be discussed. Remember, digital citizenship was already a module on its own in 4, and now we're just combining it with concepts of ICT. Same with personal computers, we're combining it with mobile devices. How does mobile devices link up with personal computers? Basically, let's face it, we're using our mobile devices, our phones, as little computers. They can do all the same functions, just in a more compact way. So how does that link up? And then we have modules 3, 4, 5, 6. Modules 3 is file management. So file management has always been there. Word is still there. Spreadsheet is still there. And then we're introducing a brand new baby to our Computer Practice family, which is notebooks or OneNote. But I'm going to explain that in a little bit more detail. So let's go over to the next slide. The new content that you guys are going to have to focus on is the following. Number one, file management. File management has always been part of the Computer Practice in 5 syllabus. It's still part of it. So yes, you're still going to have to do file management in creating folders and files, moving them around and making screenshots of them. So that's always been part, that's nothing new, so that stays the same. Secondly, we have Microsoft Word and Mail Merge, it's very much still there. But remember, you still have your ordinary Word manipulation that needs to happen, so that is still there, but remember, Mail Merge is still there and we need to focus on that. Then number three is Microsoft Excel. Now Microsoft Excel, there's quite a few new things concerning Microsoft Excel. Managing and editing worksheets, they are still there, so you're still going to have to do your normal formulas. You still have to go and insert and open a spreadsheet and insert formulas and borders and stuff. That's still there, and the normal formulas that you've dealt with, they are still there. But creating and editing a graph and a chart, that's new. Remember, it wasn't part of the N4 syllabus, but it's now part of N5. And then we have introduction of more advanced formulas. Brace yourself, because you're now going to have to deal with if calculations and age lookups. These were usually part of the old curriculums in 6 curriculum for CP, but now we're taking those two elements and putting it into N5, which is actually a great thing. All right, and the last thing that we're going to add is, as I mentioned, Microsoft OneNote. Great collaboration software, great fun, and also very, very easy, surprisingly very, very easy. So there in a nutshell, you have your new content that you need to focus on and get yourself prepared then. How to approach the modules? Well, obviously, easy to follow power break activities are still there, and more in-depth end-of-module assessments, not only for the practical parts, but also for the theory parts of the textbook. I also just need to mention this valuable online support also that we can give you for Computer Practice, not N4 and N5. The first one is go and visit the author's YouTube channel. The author of this textbook, myself, Mario Hartnick, one of the authors, co-authors. I have a YouTube channel. Go and visit it, Computer Practice with Mistakes. There's quite a lot of content already there, and I'm developing as I go along. So so do yourself a favor, go and check it out. And then, of course, we have the Computer Practice Facebook page that was originally created by the curriculum designer, Bertie Beitendach. And you can go and visit that Facebook page. Just type in Computer Practice into Facebook and go and check it out yourself. Remember, the only constant thing in life is change. And the best thing for you to do is to take it on with both hands. Thank you so much.